Assalamu alaikum. Beloved scholar, how are you? I hope you are well by the grace of Almighty Allah. And welcome to my today's English class. And in my previous class, I started the rules of with clause and without clause. And I completed three grammatical item, especially the rules of noun, adjective, verb. We have already completed to discuss the three parts of speech rules. First one is noun, second the rules of adjective, and last one is the rules of verbs. Okay, and today I am going to discuss the another remaining only one parts of speech rules named adverb. Adverb. And I am starting my class on adverb. I think you will give a pure concentration on my lecture. Okay? And rule one, write down. Rule one. If you find in a sentence gap plus noun or subject, okay? If you find in a sentence at the beginning of the gap plus noun or subject, then you will have to express adverb parts of speech. Are you clear, beloved student? Then I am giving to you an example by the help of this first rule. Okay, in the box word there will be given the general, general, general. General is called the adjective parts of speech. General is called adjective parts of speech. That is why to fill the gap we will be able to apply here the adverb parts of speech. Why? Because we have already found here the gap. Yes, gap plus subject or noun, anyone, and subject has been depicted nicely here, the position of man. That is why we will amend in this box word or gap word named general. And what is the exact adverb of general? And adverb general is the general. That is why instead of general, we will express our right answer as parts of speech is generally. Okay, that is why you will only apply here according to the rules of first, then adverb. Your right answer will be generally, generally. Okay, and I am going to discuss the number two rule. Rule 2. Okay, if you find in a sentence principal verb plus gap plus full stop, you know well that full stop indicates the ending of a complete sentence in any particular type of sentence. I am telling you that what's the exact rules here. The rule number two is if you find here the principal verb plus gap plus full stop, then you will have to put the adverb parts of speech here. Okay, and adverb indicates in most cases ly or double ly. Okay, as suffix in a root word, we will try to apply ly or double ly anyone to indicate the adverb parts of speech. Okay. A boy runs quick. I have written an example to you. A boy runs. A boy has been added here, the subject third person singular number, and it has been also added s, just with principal verb. Okay, this rule is principal verb plus gap plus full stop. That is why runs, it is called the position of PB, that's mean principal verb. Okay, and this another portion here is the gap in a box word in the number 4 item called with clause, there will be given the position of quick. That is why we will add here quickly. Why? Because just after gap we have also found here the position of full stop. That is why we will apply the parts of speech adverb in a box. Okay, the dog greed. Is it right? No, because yet is the past form of it. At as the past form of it. That is the past form of it. That is why there is another gap after principal verb. Okay, greed in the box word. And what types of parts of speech? Greed is called noun. Okay, that is why we will change here in an adverb position. Greedily. 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 Okay. Now, I am going to discuss with you the most important rules in your any sorts of upcoming examination you may find common. And what is the rules here I am discussing? Write down. It is the most important topic to you. Rule 3. If you find subject plus AB plus gap plus PB, if you find here the position of subject plus AB, that's mean auxiliary verb plus gap plus principal verb. I discussed with you in my previous two classes, okay, to indicate the position of principal verb after auxiliary verb. Okay, and after auxiliary verb there will be two structures of verb, okay, nicely applied here. That's mean AB plus PB plus ING or B3. Any one may be applied just after any sorts of auxiliary verb, especially the to be verb. We know well that to be verbs are am, is, are, was, were, shall be or will be plus verb plus ing or be 3. And if you find that after to be verb plus be 3, then it will be counted as the passive formation of verb. Okay. And when you will find just the auxiliary verb plus principal verb plus ing, then it will be counted the structure of any continuous tense. And you know very well the exact structure of continuous. There are three types of continuous tense: the present continuous, past continuous, and future continuous tense. Okay. I have written a sentence on whiteboard. Look at the sentence that I have written on whiteboard. She has careful picked up the sleeping child. She has careful picked up the sleeping child. Okay. And here in the sentence, there has been given the position of auxiliary verb. And what types of auxiliary verb has is called to have verb. To have verb means have, has, had, shall have, and will have. And in a present perfect tense, we may apply two particular types of to have verb. First one, have, and another, has, according to the subject. Okay. And she is called the third person singular number as subject in this sentence. Okay. That is why has been applied third person singular number as subject. And careful, and you know it is very simple. Whenever you will find just root word means main word. Okay. Care, C-A-R-E, care. Care, full. Full always indicates the parts of speech adjective. As for example, careful, mindful, sorrowful, beautiful. And full always indicates in a particular word adjective. Okay. And careful, picked. Picked, ed. That means ed has been added here according to the structure of present perfect tense. And before gap, we have found here the position of to have verb. That means has. Okay. And after what here? Careful plus B3. The position of B3. Okay. That is why according to the given number rule 3 of adverb, we will undoubtedly apply the position of careful. Okay. We will only amend here. We will only correct here the position of adjective. Instead of adjective, we will certainly apply here the position of adverb. What's the formation of adverb? Carefully. Right answer will be careful, and C-A-R-E, care, F-U, double L Y. She has carefully picked up the sleeping child. Okay? And I am giving another example to you by the help of the same rule. You will be able to answer this incorrect sentence here. Okay, they have They have tactful managed the difficult problem easily. There are subject here is they plus have has been applied as to have verb plus gap plus B3 and without tactful the sentence will be they have managed the difficult problem. They have managed the difficult problem. How he has managed this problem? Okay, right answer will be tactfully will be right answer here. Okay, and if you find here the instead of tactfully, if you find here just N-I-C-E, nice, yes, right answer will be N-I-C-E-L-Y. They have nicely managed the difficult problem, and it will only depend the word inside the box. Okay, inside the box you will be able to justify the what will be the correct parts of speech by the help of noun, verb, adjective and adverb here. And write down number 4 rule. If you find here the principal verb, that's mean PV plus gap plus adjective, and if you find here the principal verb plus gap plus adjective, then you will have to apply adverb. Okay, She played extreme well. As usual, we use extremely sorry. I am extremely sorry. Here, extreme. And she plays well. She plays well. How? She plays well. She plays well extremely. Extremely will be right. Why? Because before gap, there has been given the position of principal verb, and after blank or after gap, there has been also given the position of adjective. To identify the position of principal verb plus gap plus adjective, then we may certainly apply here the position of adverb. And what will be the adverb of extreme? Extremely. Why? Because ly or double ly, I told you in my starting class here, the ly or double ly indicates the position of adverb. That is why extremely will be right answer. In number 4 is the part of first paper, especially the with clothes and without clothes that I am taking and class. I took three classes on these rules. Okay, I am going to discuss the another number five rules. Okay, and whenever you will find the article plus gap plus adjective, article plus gap plus article plus gap plus adjective, okay, then we will apply here the position of adverb. And what is the structure here? Structure is, if you find article plus gap plus adjective, then we will apply here the position of adverb. Acha. Yamin is a good boy. Look at this sentence. Yamin is a good boy. Here, before gap, there has been given the position of determiner. Determiner is called the part of piece article. Okay, and article. Article is called the determiner, and article has been applied here the part of piece as adjective. Then Yamin is a very good boy. And just the exact rules of noun, adjective, verb and adverb before starting our practice on with clause and without clause. Okay, inshallah, in my next class I will discuss about any board question of number 4 and number 5, with clause and without clause. And I hope you will take a good preparation regarding the rules of same parts of speech here. Okay, and until then, be well, and you will take preparation to attend the next practice class, inshallah. Okay, next to see you. Allah Hafiz. Assalamu alaikum.